Hi friends, welcome to Srinu Technologies, myself Ram Kumar. Today we will discuss more details about Process Studio and Blue Prism. So in our previous videos we have seen how to use collections and then loop through each record in a collection and then get the intended data and then we can play with the data, right, or process the data. So we have seen that. Now we will go to another stage, which is the page reference. So page reference takes the process down to the start of another page. When the end of that page is reached, the process comes back up to the page reference stage that called it. So in simple terms, what I mean to say is, so this is like a best practice. So this stage is used to implement some best practice. Okay, think that you have 1000 lines of code in normal programming language. So what we do is, for maintainable perspective, readability perspective, we break down into multiple files, right, and then we call our methods actually, and then we call each method whenever it is used, and then it increase the reusability as well. Similarly, think that we have a big flow chart, okay, in our process, and then there are some things which are commonly used. So what we can do is, this kind of commonly used can be grouped into another section which is called page, and then we can refer it from the main page. That's what this is saying. And then we can have a hierarchy of multiple pages into it. Means page 1 is calling page 2, page 2 is calling page 3, and once the page 3 is completed, it comes back to the page 2, and once page 2 is completed, it comes, the control comes back to the page 1. So this is the meaning of page reference. So let's go back to the tool and see how we can create a page, and then how we can call the sub pages which we are creating, or the sub process which we are creating from the main process. So page is nothing but a sub process. So we have a main page. So main page is the main process. So from this main process, we can call the sub process, which is called a page here in this Blue Prism notation. Okay, let's go back to the tool and then create a new page, and then we will try to call it one after the other, right? Yeah. Yes, so here is our main page, or the flow which we have created earlier, right? So this is a simple process, but imagine, think that this looping is there, right? This is a bit complex thing. Think that this is a bit complex thing, and before this loop there is some process is happening, and then after this end is happening. So think that this looping is very common for, so it is repeating in your process. So what we can do is, we can move this as a sub process to a new page. And you should understand that when you start a Process Studio, when you start on go button, by default it will start from main page. Even though you have multiple pages, so the process execution will start from main page. This is one thing you have to remember. So let's create one page, and then I will tell you in detail how a sub process can be triggered directly, or by default how the main page can refer to the sub process or the sub page actually. Main page, main process. Rest all pages will be sub process. Okay, thumb rule. So let's now create a new page. So how I am creating a new page is, beside the new main page, I am just right clicking and then I am saying new. If you see, all the other things are disabled because we don't have pages now. Once we create a new page, the other things will be enabled, and then we can see how we can use those parameters or the clicks. So let us create a new. So we want to give a page name. So what I am saying is, what is a page name? Loop page. Some name I have given, okay, and then I am saying okay. So now a page is created, and again by default, as you know, start and end will be the default stages, okay. Now what we will do is, we want to copy this to the this thing, right? So what I will do is, I am just copying the loop here on main page. Whatever we have, the order loop, means the loop section is just, I have selected Control C, and then coming to this loop page, and I am saying Control V. So I am copying it here, right? I am just rearranging. So I will just rearrange the end section or end stage, and then so that it will be easy for us. And then I will do the linking. I will do this linking as well. So, but we have the stages only, we don't have the data. So what you have to do is, we have to copy the data as well into the corresponding page. So I am copying this and then I am pasting it here. So actually it's not copy paste. So the context you should understand is, so the variable should be here, and then once you are calling this page or sub process from the main page, this will be easily executed. Okay, so I'm just saving this. So I'm saying it's a new page created. So try to use a meaningful description here, so that for each save you will see. So I will show you how each save or each version is showcased to you in the control room. Okay, so now we have, so we have the main page. So we have used these variables there. So I'm deleting here, right? I'm deleting here, and then so this thing which is there, which we have kept there, I'm deleting this as well. So we have just have the main page. So we have the process of the main page. Now what I can do is, I can, so we have a page stage here if you see on the left. So I'm dragging that page stage and I'm leaving it here. So when I'm dropping that here, there will be some default options shown to me. So what it is saying is, you want to create a reference to existing page. What is the first option is saying? The first option is saying, there is some existing sub page created already. Do you want to keep a reference to it? Yes, that is the intention we have, right? So we have created some page called loop page. We want to call that page from this main page, means a reference we want to create. So the first option is the one which will suit for us now. But for the second option, so something like, when you select this, you are creating, you want to first create a new page and then create a reference to it. Okay, that is what it is doing. And the third one is, you want to create a new page and I don't want to create a reference to it. So these options are, you should use according to your process of your designing or your scenario. So we'll go with this first option, and then I say next. So when you say next, if you see here, only loop page is there, because there are only one loop page which we have created here, so it is coming here. Okay, I will say finish. So what we'll do is, for your understanding, I will create some new pages. Just some random new pages I am creating here. If you see here, I am creating page 2, page 3, and I'll, this is what it is there. So in main page, if you click now, if you double click now, right? So if you see here in the drop down, all the things are shown here, all three. So which one you want to make a reference, right? So we'll go to loop page only. So this, I think for your understanding, I have added this page 2 and page 3. So example, if I drag it once again and I leave it, so if you see here, once you say create a reference to an existing page, next, it is showing all the pages which are available, right? That is how it is. So I'm cancelling this, and I will cancel this page also. Now if you see here, all these, the other types of buttons are enabled here, right? So duplicate, rename, delete, cut copy, find references, manage process. Find reference means, when you click this, this page is called from which page, means who is the parent of this. So we'll get to know once you are clicking on this. So we will use this kind of, we will get to know the importance here when you have the complete process or pages in place. Okay, for now, just deal with how to create a page and then how to reference this page from the main page. So I'm deleting this unwanted page 2, and also I will delete this unwanted page 3. So it might create some confusion right now. So we have two pages, as I told. So one is main page, loop page. Loop page is our sub process, okay? And main page is our main page. So once you create a page, I need to just link them, okay? Let me just increase the font here for your understanding. So this is the loop stage, right? And then once I double click this, it will just open a window, and then you select me which page we are referring to. That's it. There is no other things. You will not see the content which is there in loop page. To see the content in loop page or the flow chart in loop page, you have to click the loop page and then see it like this. Okay, so what I will do is I will just save, and I have done all the links ready. So when I do a refresh, there are no errors, there are no validation errors. Okay, so I am in loop page. You might be thinking, if I click on go, it will start from this start. Okay, but no. So I am making it slow. So this is the debugging speed or control plane is just seen, right? So this is for debugging purpose. So I kept in slow mode now. Now, if I click on go, so what do you expect? Do you think the start, the execution will start from this start or the start which is there in main page? Yes, I think you have got the context. It will not start from this start, it should start from main page start. Let us see. So I am clicking on go. So if you see here, immediately the main page got activated. Now the loop page is getting called. It went to here, it is looping now, right? So I'll make it this a bit faster, so that, because we already know this, how to do it, right? So it is going to the loop. So now I'll make it slow, so as we are on fifth. So now it came to end. Now it comes to the main page, and then it came to end. You got you right? So it came, it started from start. It came to, so I'm just refreshing it. So this started from start, it came to loop page. So to execute the loop page, the page means it's a tabbing effect happened. So it went to loop page, again it came to start of this page, and then it came to loop. It has done all the loop thing and it has ended. And then it, once it came to end, it did not stop here. The process execution did not stop once it see and end. Normally what you might be thinking, once there is an end, it will stop. No, once it reaches the end stage in the main page, then only the process stops. So once the control reaches the end of loop page, then the control is coming back to the loop page here, and then it came back to end of main page. So this is the concept of page reference, right? Hope you all understood. So we have some important concept of inputs and output parameters. Okay, let's go back to the PPT to have some theory there. Hope you have understood what is a page reference. So for, I am reiterating, page reference is nothing but, don't confuse, when you have a long process, we will break the main process into sub process. So each sub process is kept in a separate page, and the main process is there in main page. Simple. Page, process. Main page, main process. A page reference or a simple page is referring to a sub process. That's it, right? So we need to see something about input output parameters. So why these are important? When we have everything on main page, we have seen that we have some parameters like, or we have some data items like collections, and then looping was happening over the collection. But we need to have some, if we are moving this to a sub process, right? The sub process might require some input parameters which are governed in the main page. You got me? Means main page is calling the sub process, and it will say that the starting point is this, because main page should have the control over the sub page. Anywhere is the same thing, right? So when we have a sub process or sub page, the sub page input data should be triggered from the main page. So what is an input parameter? Means passing a value, it can be string, integer, date, collection, to a process. Here it can, you can take it as sub process, is carried out using input parameters. Means when you are giving some input data to a process or a page, right? So that is termed as input parameters in Blue Prism. So what is output parameters, right? So when your sub process is, logic is done, sometimes in our case when the collection is looped through, so we have read each thing and then we have not seen any output, means we have just processed the data, means we did not create any data. What we have, the data which is there in the collection is just processed, and then we stored it into a variable. That's what we did.
we did not create any new data. So sometimes there might be chances where we have created a new data and then that data should be returned back to the main calling process, main page or calling page. Example, in this case, main page called loop page. Loop page might call page 1 or page 2 or something like that, right? So if you are in page 2 or some other page, if the after the process is over, you want to return some data to the calling page, so that is termed as output parameters. So in simple, a page or a sub process, whatever data items it is using to start the process, those are called input parameters. Once everything is completed, whatever data items which is returned at the output is called output parameters. Simple. So let's go back to the tool and then do the exercise on this, and then you'll get to know more about this. Right? It's very simple. Let's go back to the tool. Yes. So here we have a loop page, but there is no data required here. Right? And then here we have a loop page. Here also no data required. So think that we have a collection of 5 data, and then so think that I will add some more data to this. Okay, I will add some more. So if you want to add some more, you just click on add row. So I have kept total 5 records now. Okay, so it is just like this. Okay, so order 1. So I'll quickly do it. So it is just, so this sometimes this kind of data preparation might be this thing. So what I will do is I will keep some names in location. So fastly something I kept. Okay, so I will keep something like again Pune here, or something which we did not take. What we take, Vijayawada or something. Okay, something like this. And then here Guntur. Okay, some just arbitrary values I am taking, something. Okay, some OT, something like this. Okay, there are some 10 cities, or means where the order is placed, that is what it is saying. So if you say okay, once you say okay and then do a refresh, we have 10 data. So now just think, main page will call the loop page or the page reference, and then it will send an input parameter stating that I send me the city name which is in order 5th or order 6th. It will give a number, it will give the counter number. So for that particular order, it should return me the city name. So that is our intention here, simple thing, right? Okay, so before that you have to get to the page. So once, as I told you, input parameters are associated with the start stage and output parameters are associated with the end stage. Means anything to be processed to start with start stage. So the parameters which are mapped to a start stage are called, can be called input parameters. And all the, once the processing is done, whatever the value which is there as current value. So a data item will have initial value and current value, right? So whatever the current value is there will be mapped to the end stage, and then that will be termed as output parameters. So our intention is to get the index. So this is the start properties. So we are in start now. So to add the input parameters, I need to just say add here in the start properties explorer. So I just said add. So it is asking me what is the name you want to give. So I will say counter name. So it is a counter or index. So index. So index of order. So this is what we want. What is the data type? I want to give it as a number. So store in which value? So the coming value, which is the input parameter, the data type and value will be coming as input to this process, right? So you should store in a variable, right? So when I click on this, if you see here, when I'm hovering on this icon, you can see something like click here to automatically create a data item of the required type using the name of this field. So when you click on this, if you see here, you can see on the right,
Index is the data item which is not present earlier. So when you clicked on this icon, it has used the name as the data item name and then the type as data item, and the default value will be 0 of course, or empty. Okay, let's see that how it is. So this is stored in index. So if you have already have some value, if you already have think that this is already there, right? If think that is already there, so you can just drag and drop here if you want. See, so simple. If it is not there, you can click on this icon, it will be getting created. If it is already there, just drag it. So whatever the input parameters is coming into this process or the page will be stored in this index value. So that is over, and now let me increase the size. So this is our index, right? So we need to have some output. So what is the output we thought? What is our input? What is the for the corresponding index, right? Get me the location. So when you are seeing, right, when you are actually looping through this, you are getting the location and already populated in this loop, right? So we want to just get this done. So what, so we want to location as the data item which needs to be returned. So what we need to do is you have to click on end. So this is the end explorer, and then when you say add, you will be in the right side. If you see here, you will see all the parameters which are available, and then it will ask which one to be sent as output parameters. Okay, if you see here, get the value from means you have to drag that particular data item here. You cannot create a data item here. See, when there is, when you are talking about input parameters, you are creating a data item, because whatever is coming in will be stored in that. But here it is saying get value from means the value is already there, and that has to be exposed or returned as an output output variable, right? That is the intention here. So what I want to return, I want to return the location. This is my value. So once I drop the location, data type is default became text. See, I will do it again. So remove, add. So if you see here, there is no data type selected here. When I am dropping the collection in the get value from field, so the text is become, because we already know that the location is data type, so that Blue Prism will defaultly set the data type for you. So no need to disturb this, but you need to give a name for this. So instead of saying location, we will say city name. So city name, so this will not be stored in this process. Okay, as this is output variable, this will be not be shown in this place. But the start thing, what is the variable which is there in the start, is stored in this index variable. So we have created the input variable and the output variable for our process. But how to use that input variable? We did not use that input variable. So what we will do is, when we are looping through it, actually we have collection of 10. But when I pass 3, it should go through the third record, stop there, and then return me that location value. You are getting me? We have 10 records, but think that the index value is 3. What it should do is, it should go to the third value. If it is matching, if the record is third value, it should just return me the location value, right? So this is what is happening here. So what I will do is, I will add some processing here. So I will take a new data item called counter, and then because it has to count the number of rows, right? So default value I am keeping as 0, and then I am saving this. Let me increase the size. So this is the counter for us, right? So what I have to do is, I have to take one calculation stage. So I will use the existing calculation stage and copy paste, and then I will say counter, increment the counter. So what I will do is, I will remove the existing expression which came with my copy paste. Store in value also, you should be very cautious when you are doing a copy paste. So this is my counter. So what I want to do, I want to, for each record I have to increment, and then again I have to keep it in counter. Okay, so then I need to have a decision, means once the counter is being incremented, you should understand whether the index is matching with the counter or not, right? You understood, right? So you have to have a decision box. So I will connect them, don't worry. So decision is check index. right? What it is doing is, I am checking whether this counter is equal to index. I am checking this. Is the counter equal to index? That is what the expression is saying. If it is yes, if it is no, so if it is yes, we have to stop the loop there and then get the location value as the output parameter. If it is not, you have to continue the loop. That is our option, right? So let me increment this as well. So check index is our thing. So let me link, so assign this thing and then counter to decision box, and then decision box, if it is yes, yes means what? It is matching value. Matching means what? We have to exit, right? So exit should be going to the end operation. So let me first place this here so that this can be mapped to end. So just I will first do the connection, so that otherwise it is not matching, we have to go, we have to continue the loop. If you see here, it's not looking good, but this is how it is. So what I will do is, I will add some anchors to add some beauty here, okay. So I will add one more anchor to see, right. So let me pull this into the alignment. So if it is no, right, if it is no, it is doing this. So let me start it from again. So what you have to do is, if it is yes, it has to come to end, right? If it is no, it has to continue the loop. I think you just saw how we can modify to make it more beautiful, right? So now I did this. So now what is happening? So index is coming, it is looping through it, it is checking for the index. When the index is matching, it is coming out and then it is coming to the end stage. There is no issue in stopping the loop in the middle, right? And then, so you might get confused where we are, how we are sending the output parameters. In the end, we have already configured that whatever the value is there in the location should be treated as output parameter, right? That is how it is. So this is the calling. So now we will come back to the main page, and then here in the loop, earlier when you selected, when you double click this, you have got only page, rest all were empty here, if you remember. But here there is something shown as inputs. For a page, what is saying is, you have to give some input here, give the input here. So I will just hard code for now as 2. Otherwise I can send it to a data variable also, but for now, for time being, I am hard coding as 2. And what is the output? So if you see here, we have given the CT name as the output, if you remember, that is the coming here. So if you see here, there is no CT name or some variable in our already existing in the data item in the panel right side. So what I am doing is, I am clicking on this icon so that it will create a data item called CT name for me. So I am closing this. If you see here, CT name is just created for us, right? So this is this. I will make it big so that you will use it easily. So I am just saving it, okay, and then I will do a refresh also. Let's run this. If you remember, we are asking for what is the CT name on index 2. That's what we are asking for. So let me run in a very slow mode or a normal mode or between normal and slow, right, and then let me run this. So start, it came, it went to a page reference, it went there, it got the index value as 2, if you see here. So first loop is happening, it got the location and order ID. Now it is checking, decision is not happening, it is no, it is going to the second loop now. So it got the location, it got the order ID, it counter incremented to 2, 2. So now both should be equal and then it should come out. If you see, it is coming out of the loop, it came to end. It will be returned back to the main page, and then if you see here, the CT name is exactly Chennai, which is correct. So if you go back to the loop and see, what is the second row in, so the second location is Chennai. So we have got the exact value which we want, right? So this is how we can easily understand what are input parameters and output parameters associated with pages, right? Hope you have understood. Keep watching our videos and keep learning.